For today's lesson, you will need two books, a paper plate, the stinkiest sock you can find, a toilet paper roll, a sock ball or any other type of ball, and some tape.
All right, kindergarten, PE starts in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good morning, kindergartners. It's Coach Kevin. I've got another PE for us. Let me turn this music down. Music off. Pretty cool, right? All right, I'm gonna start my timer. We're gonna start with a warm-up, and I've got a new song for us to sing. So this is a call and response song, all right? So sing it with me, here we go. Give me a big M. Give me a little M. Don't give me no pop, no pop. Don't give me no juice, no juice. Just give me some milk. Just give me some milk. Got it? Give me a big eye. Give me a little eye. Don't give me no pop, no pop. Don't give me no juice, no juice. Just give me some milk. Just give me some milk. Give me a big L. Give me a little L. Don't give me no pop, no pop. Don't give me no juice, no juice. Just give me some milk. Just give me some milk. You know what letter comes next? If you guess K, you got it. Give me a big K. Give me a little K. Don't give me no pop, no pop. Don't give me no juice, no juice. Just give me some milk. Just give me some milk. All right, friends. I want to teach you something called a coordination. And this is going to be a fun challenge for our body. So this is a do what I do. So we're going to do this together. So try to follow along. First thing we're going to do with our left hand, touch our shoulder, and then with our right hand, we're gonna give the stop sign. So it's gonna be shoulder tap, stop. Shoulder tap, stop. Let's just do this together for a little bit. See if you can find some coordination. One more time. Very good. Now we're going to try coordination with the feet. And this one's going to look like this. It's going to go heel with our right foot, and then toe touch with a little bit of bend with our left foot. So do this with me. Heel, toe. Heel, toe. Heel, toe. Good. Heel, toe. Very good. Now we're going to try to incorporate both of those. So as our hand touches our shoulder, we're going to do our heel touch. And then as we do the toe touch, we're going to give the stop sign. So it's going to look like this. So do this with me. Feels good. I can feel my brain waking up a little bit. I like it. Awesome. Now, if this was tricky, I don't want you to give up. And that's the theme of today, is to never give up. It's a fancy word called perseverance. And later in the PE, I'm going to read you a story about perseverance. So if anything today is hard, I don't want you to quit. I want you to keep practicing and remember that we're Yetis, so we might not be able to do it yet, but with practice and perseverance, we will get it. Remember, what is now really easy for us to do was once really hard. So if you can remember when we're babies, remember how hard it was to walk? We couldn't even walk, we had to crawl. But we didn't give up, we kept practicing, and finally we can walk. And now walking is really easy for us, but once it was really hard, all right? All right, friends, it's time for our first game of the day. And so what you're gonna need to get is the two books that I mentioned at the beginning. Get your two books and get your sock ball, or if you have a real ball that you wanna use, that would work too, all right? So this game is called Foot Trap Soccer. So I have my sock ball, I got my two books. Now, so you can see, I'm gonna put my books pretty close together. However, for you, you can put your books as close or as far as you want. Now this is an I go, we go, so I want you to watch me and then we're gonna play together for a few minutes. So this is my turn, I go. So I'm gonna take my sock ball, I'm gonna start it on one of my books, okay? What I need to do is use my feet only and kick my sock ball and get it to stop on my other book. That's what's called a trap. I'm trapping it there. You're trapped, sock ball, you're not going anywhere. And then I'm gonna dribble it back, get it to stop on my other book. Trap, oh, trap, trapped ya. And then we're gonna go back and forth. Okay? So, now it's time for us to all go together. So I hope you've got your materials ready. And we're gonna play this game together. Now, one other thought. If you are a competitive person and you like to keep score and you like to count, you can see how many times you can trap your sock ball in a minute. All right? And I'm going to do this too. If you don't want to count and you just want to play just for fun, that's okay too. But when this gets to 3 minutes, I'm going to see how many traps I can get in 1 minute. Here I go. One, two, three. Try to use both your feet. See if you can use both your feet. 4, 5, 6. Seven, 8, 9, 10. Uh-oh, 5 seconds. 11. All right, I got 11 in a minute. Now, what I'm gonna do, since we've just got a couple more minutes left, I'm gonna rest for a little bit, and I'm gonna try to do that again, and I'm gonna see if I can beat 11. And if you don't wanna count, and you don't wanna keep scoring, and you just wanna have fun, you can go back and forth, and till our next activity. So I'm gonna start in 3 seconds and see if I can beat 11. Go! So I'm gonna go for another minute, see if I can beat 11. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, I'm using the bottom. bottom of my foot to roll it. That's fun. 8. See how I'm rolling it with the top of my, or the bottom of my foot? 9. Ten. Uh-oh. 11. I got 8 seconds. See if I can beat it. 12. See if I can get one more. 13. All right, I beat my score. So that's called foot trap soccer. I hope you liked it. All right, I'm gonna get rid of my books. Get rid of my softball. And we're gonna move into our little movement of the day. So last week we talked about our heart being the size of our fist. It's a muscle. And the stronger we make our heart, the more adventures we get to go on. So in 1 minute, we're gonna strengthen our heart with some fun moves. So the first move we're gonna do is called a turtle triangle crawl. So we have to use our imagination here. We just need a small space. And I'm going to imagine I'm a little turtle, all right? So I'm a little turtle, and I'm going to crawl to the point of my triangle, and I'm going to turn, and then I'm going to go to my other point, turn, and then go to my other point. So I just made a triangle. Then I'm going to go back the other way, and I'm going to keep making get as many triangles as I can in 30 seconds, all right? So now it's time for us all to go, we all go. Ready? We're all gonna be little turtles and make our triangles. On your mark, get set, here we go. Crawl to that top point, turn, turn, turn. Now I'm gonna go back the other way. Turtles crawl nice and slow. And I made a triangle. Pretty cool. All right, so next, we're gonna do some SpongeBob SquarePants jumps. So we're gonna hold our pants like SpongeBob. We're gonna make a square. So I'm gonna jump forward, jump sideways, jump back, jump sideways, and I made a square. Cause I'm SpongeBob SquarePants, right? Remember him? Bring it around town. All right, so are we all gonna go together? Let's do it. Ready? We all go. Jump forward, jump to the side, jump back to the side. SpongeBob SquarePants, let's go the other way. There, forward, side. Back. Ooh, I think we can get another one in. Here we go. Forward. Side. Back. Side. Can we do one more real quick? Side. Front. Side. Back. Good job. Those are our SpongeBob SquarePants. Next, we're going to do Silly Billy circles. So I'm going to place my hand on the ground, and I'm going to walk in a circle. Then I have to rotate my hand. Then I'm gonna take my left hand and go the other way. Remember, this is my turn. You just watch. All right, Silly Billy circle. So we gotta be silly too with these. Have a silly face. All right, we all go. Ready? Here we go. Whoa, 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 whoa. Silly Billy circles. I'm being silly. All right, other way. Billy Billy. Making a circle. Let's go around the other way. Silly Billy, wee, whoa, silly. Let's go one more time. Whoa, Silly Billy. All right, woo. Okay, last movement is called a dancing diamond. So a diamond is almost like two triangles together. So I'm gonna start here. And I'm going to dance to the tip, then I'm going to turn and dance to this tip, dance to this tip, and then dance to this tip. And I just made a diamond. All right, are you ready? Here we go. Dancing diamond. Let's dance it this way. Dancing diamond. What other dance moves do we know? You know this one? I like this dance move. We're gonna need some music for the next round. Maybe the moonwalk. Ooh. All right. Now we get a rest. So let's get some water. All right, so that was a practice. We're gonna do that again. We'll do the turtles in the triangle. We're gonna do the SpongeBob SquarePants. We'll do the Silly Billy Circles and the Dancing Diamond. And I'm definitely gonna turn on some music for this next round. So get some water. And I'm gonna see if I can feel my heartbeat. So I'm gonna take my two fingers. I'm gonna put them in my neck somewhere. And I'm looking for a beat. So it's gonna beat. And I can feel my heart beating. That means my heart is nice and strong and healthy. It's a steady beat. Awesome. Now, after we do this next round, my heartbeat should be, do you think it should be slower or faster? If you said faster, you're right. The more we work, the more our muscle and our heart has to work, our heart muscle has to work, and that's gonna make our heart beat faster. And what it's doing is sending all that blood from the heart, it's pumping the blood to our arms and our legs that are doing the movement so that they have oxygen and they have energy to move. And that's one of the important things that the heart does. So, let's get ready. Let's turn on some music. Play some music. See if we can do this. Okay, get ready. Here it comes. Get ready to move, everybody. Okay. So remember, we're gonna do our turtles first. So this is I go. My turn. Just watch me. I'm gonna crawl slow like a turtle to the top of my triangle. Turn, go to the bottom of my triangle, turn. All right, and that's our turtle crawl. All right, ready? We're all gonna go. 3, 2, 1, we all go. Turtle crawls. All right, let's go the other way. Remember, turtles crawl slow. Good job. All right, let's rest, shake it out. All right, I go, my turn, just watch me. We're gonna do our SpongeBob SquarePants jumps. We're gonna jump in a square. We'll jump forward, side, back, and side. Don't forget to hold on to your pants so they don't fall off. Woo! All right, 10 seconds. 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1, we all go. Forward, side, back, side. Let's go the other way. Side, front, side. Back, let's go a little faster. Awesome job. Jumping in a square. One more time. Good job, friends. Okay, it's time for the Silly Billy Circles. I go, watch me. Remember that we're gonna put one hand down. This hand has to rotate. And then we'll go the other way. All right, we're all gonna go. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Don't forget your silly face. Oh, we can do one more. I'm getting a little dizzy. All right. Okay. It's our last one, our dancing diamond. So remember, we have a point here. We're going to dance to this point. Dance to this point. And that's a diamond. All right, are we ready to all go? We're all gonna go in 8 seconds. Here we go. You can dance like me or do your own dance moves. We did it! Nice job! Give yourself a round of applause! Pat on the back! Rocket cheer! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! We did it! All right. Music off. Isn't technology cool? I love technology. Although sometimes it can be a bit frustrating and a bit distracting. However, I'm really enjoying technology during these times because I'm still able to teach you all, even though we can't be together safely, I'm still able to teach you PE with technology. And that's one of the reasons I love technology. So we're getting water. Let's check out how much time we got. So what we're gonna do now is get ready for our next game. So I mentioned at the beginning that we needed a paper plate. I mentioned that you needed the stinkiest sock you could find. Oh, that's a stinky one. You needed a toilet paper roll and you needed some tape. All right, and we're gonna play a game called Paper Plate Motor. And you'll see what that means here in a moment. So why I like the stinky sock is I like to stuff it in my toilet paper roll. It just gives it a little extra weight. If you don't have a stinky sock, you could just fill it with some tissue paper. So that would work, some Kleenex, but now it's just got a little bit of weight to it. I got my paper plate and I've got my tape. Now, if you don't have tape, you could use the same books you used earlier, but what we're gonna do now is take, this is I Go. I want you just to watch me right now. We'll do I Go, We Go. So I'm just gonna give myself a start line. So my start line is gonna be, let's do it right here. And if you want, you can even write the word start or a big S. And now I need a turn line. I'm going to make my turn line over here. Okay? And let's do some practice now. Again, if you want to make yours longer, go for it. So I'm going to take my toilet paper roll and put it at my start line. I'm going to take my paper plate motor and I'm going to use my motor. Oh, I got to go. Ah, go, go, go. Now, it ran off a little off course. That's okay. I can. If I need to use my hand, that's okay to get it back on course. But if I use my hand, I got a 5 second dance penalty. 4, 3, 2, 1. Now look, I got it past my turn line. So now I get to take it and move it with no penalty. And now I'm gonna use my motor and get it past, go past the start line. Got it past the start line. Now I can use my hand. And now I gotta turn, go to the turn line. I did it. Now I gotta use my hand, put it back. Come on, I'm gonna try two hands. No, that's not where I need one hand. So it takes a lot of energy. Oh, there we go, to get that motor to go. Woo! All right, so that was just practice. what we're gonna do for a challenge is we are gonna see how fast we can go there and back. That would be one. There and back, two. There and back, three. We're gonna see how fast we can do it three times. And just a reminder, when the tube passes the tape, you can use your hand to put it back. But if you have to use your hand in between the tape, you have 5 second dance penalty. All right? So, I've got my clock running. If you have a stopwatch or your parents have a stopwatch and you want to time yourself, that's really a fun way to play this. So I'm gonna start in 15 seconds and see how fast I can do three rounds, and now we can all do this together, all right? Are we ready to play? You can also pause the video at any time if you need to. All right, ready, go. That's one. Get that motor going. That's two. No touching the toilet paper roll with your plate. That's cheating. One more. Come on. You can do it. Three. 45 seconds. Whoa. That was pretty fast. All right, so that's paper plate motor. So that's what we've got for today, friends. Now, you need to pause the video because you still want to play. That's awesome. You can always come back to this game. I real quickly have a quick message, and then I'm gonna tell you a story to do our cool down. For our food rule last week, I had asked you with the help of your family or your caregivers to cook something. And I haven't heard back from anybody, but that's okay. I really hope you're all watching these. So I hope you had a chance to do some cooking, because when we cook at home, it's a really healthy way to eat because we know what ingredients we're putting in our body. For this week's food rule, I want to encourage you to eat food that is grown from plants, not made in a plant. So I want you to think about that. Listen again. I want you to eat food that is grown, not made. Grown from a plant, not made from a plant. And what that means, it's a bit tricky, it's kind of like a riddle. Food that is grown from a plant is food that comes from a seed that we put in the ground with dirt and soil and water and sun, and the sun along with the water and the soil, that food is grown into a plant and it grows food that we can eat. However, there's another type of food that's made from a plant, and I'm talking about the factory plant. Sometimes a factory is called a plant, and it's a building, and it has smokestacks and smokes coming out, and there's scientists in there, and they wear big suits, and they make food inside, and it's usually not that real. It might have some real ingredients, but a lot of it's artificial ingredients with preservatives. And they put these preservatives in the food so that they last a long, long time, so that they can sell them to people and make a lot of money. And oftentimes those foods aren't going to nourish our body as well as the food that's grown from a plant. So when you eat this week, I want you to think about, was that food grown from the earth, from a plant, or was it made in a factory? And I want to remind you, there's no good or bad, but I will say, and I feel confident saying, that the food that's grown from the plants are going to nourish our body a little bit better, or a lot better, than the food that was made in a plant. All right? So that's our food rule. So that's the PE. I want you to find a spot to sit and relax. You can even lay down and listen to this story. I'll see you all next week.
This story is called Finding a New Spring. Once upon a time, a certain tradesman was leading a caravan to another country to sell his goods. Along the way, they came to the edge of a severe hot sand desert. They asked about and found that during the daytime, the sun heats up the fine sand until it's as hot as charcoal, so no one can walk on it, not even camels. So the caravan leader hired a desert guide, one who could follow the stars, so they could travel only at night when the sand cools down. They began the dangerous nighttime journey across the desert. A couple nights later, after eating their evening meal and waiting for the sand to cool, they started out again. Later that night, the desert guide, who was driving the first cart, saw from the stars that they were getting close to the other side of the desert. He had also overeaten, so that when he relaxed, he dozed off to sleep. Then the camels, who of course couldn't tell directions by reading the stars, gradually turned to the side and went in a big, wide circle until they ended up at the same place they had started from. By then, it was morning, and the people realized that they were back at the same spot they'd camped at the day before. They lost heart and began to cry about their condition. Since the desert crossing was supposed to be over by now, they had no more water and were afraid they would die of thirst. They even began to blame the caravan leader and the desert guide. "We can do nothing without water," they complained. Then the tradesman thought to himself, "If I lose courage now, in the middle of this disastrous situation, my leadership has no meaning. If I fall to weeping and regretting this misfortune and do nothing, all these goods and camels and even the lives of the people, including myself, may be lost. I must be energetic and face the situation." So he began walking back and forth, trying to think about a plan to save them all. Remaining alert, out of the corner of his eye, he noticed a small clump of grass. He thought, "Without water, no plant could live in this desert." So he called over the most energetic of his fellow travelers and asked them to dig up the ground on that very spot. They dug and dug, and after a while they got down to a large stone. Seeing it, they stopped and began to blame the leader again, saying, "This effort is useless. We are just wasting our time." But the tradesman replied, "No, no, my friends. If we give up the effort, we will all be ruined and our poor animals will die. Let us be encouraged." As he said this, he got down into the hole, put his ear to the stone, and heard the sound of flowing water. Immediately he called over a boy who had been digging and said, "If you give up, we will all perish. So take this heavy hammer and strike the rock." The boy lifted the hammer over his head and hit the rock as hard as he could, and he himself was the most surprised when the rock split in two and a mighty flow of water gushed out from under it. Suddenly, all the people were overjoyed. They drank and bathed and washed the animals and cooked their food and ate. Before they left, they raised a high banner so that the other travelers could see it from afar and come to the new spring in the middle of the hot sand desert. Then they continued on safely to the end of their journey. So my kinder friends, the message here is don't give up too easily. Keep on trying until you reach your goal. I hope you enjoyed the story. We'll see you all next week.